Now, I have already completed your integration by parts from number 1 to 3. Now, I have in this session, I have started the remaining evaluate from number 4 to onwards. Now, I am going to solve first starting number 4. When I am discussing about the integration by parts, if it is a inverse trigonometrical functions or a logarithmic function alone, then we have using one as the second person and also one taking one as the second function and using integrating by parts. For number 4 you faced, you look sin inverse x, cos inverse x and a bi 6 sec inverse x, and that is the inverse function only alone. So using one as second function. So now I'm going to solve number 4i and then v and vi. That 3 questions I am going to solve, number I, v and vi. The important question I am going to solve, number 4i. The integration value of number I, it is sin inverse x. You look, in this case, sin inverse x is a alone function. So, taking 1 as its second function. So, since it is a inverse function alone, taking 1 as second function dx. Now, you already know, integrating by parts, the first function is constant, sin inverse x is constant. Integration of 1 into dx is equal to dx minus of derivative of integration derivative of first function 1 by 1 minus x square root over into integrating of a second function dx whole dx, because that dx for that integration and whole dx for that integration. Okay, now integration of dx is equal to x, that is equal to x sin inverse x minus of integration of dx is equal to x by 1 minus of x square dx. In this case, taking without root over as z, put z by substitute method, put z is equal to 1 minus x square. So, dz is equal to minus of 2x dx, but we have only x dx, you look x dx. So, minus 2 is divided, that is minus of 1 by 2 into dz is equal to x dx. So, instead of x dx, you can use minus half dz, particularly in this case. Now, the integration reduced to x sin inverse x, x dx. Instead of x dx, you use minus half, minus minus plus 1 by 2, that is dz by root z, because we are taking 1 minus x square as z. So, root over is root z. Root z means, you know, root z means z over half. So, that is equal to x sin inverse x z over half. When it is going to upper side, that is become minus half plus 1 is equal to half, that is 1 by 2 z to the power half divided by half. So, 2 cancel plus c, that becomes, you can write in this case, you can write in this way, you write x sin inverse x plus root z to the half means root z, that equal to root of 1 minus x square plus c. That's your answer. That is your answer of 4i. Now, I am going to do number 4, because there is a x square, there is a presence of x square. So, number v is important. So, I am going to evaluate the integration value of v. Now, going to evaluate the value of v. So, v. So, v you look, that is x square tan inverse x given v. So, no doubt inverse function from islet, the process of islet, inverse function is a first function and algebraic x square is algebraic using third function. So, the first function is a constant, tan inverse x is a constant, because inverse function taking as first function, then x square dx minus derivative of tan inverse x, 1 by 1 plus x square, you know the derivative of tan inverse x is equal to 1 by 1 plus x square, and integration of x square dx, whole dx. Just look how, you know the integration of x square is equal to x cube by 3 tan inverse x minus or x square integration of x square is equal to x cube by 3, 1 by 3 taking outside, that become x cube by 1 plus x square dx. Here, particular in this step, the power of x is equal to 2, where the numerator power of x is equal to 3. So, if the power of x is greater than 2. So, how to factorize the x cube? You look how to factorize x cube divided by 1 plus x square. 1 plus x square is equal to multiplying x became x cube plus x minus of cancelled, it becomes hello. Namaskar. Kunt. This case that is not divided, a 1 plus x square x cube is not divided by x cube. So, you can use that method using put x plus here, x is plus here minus x. It is better for understanding. You look that equal to x cube by 3 by minus x by 1 plus x square minus x by 1 plus x square, x cube by 3 tan inverse x minus 1 by 3 taking x common from both this, taking x common, that is 1 plus x square by 1 plus x square dx minus 1 by 3 minus x, that is plus 1 by 3 divided by x by 1 plus x square dx. You look 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square cancelled. Now, x cube by 3 tan inverse x minus 1 by 3 x dx plus 1 by 3 x by 1 plus x square dx. You know the integration of x dx is equal to x square by 2, but in particular in this case put z is equal to 1 plus x square. So, dz is equal to 2x dx, we have only x dx, so 2 is divided, so x dx is equal to dz by 2 is equal to x dx, so dz by 2 is equal to x dx. Now, you use x cube by 3 tan inverse x minus 1 by 3 integration of x dx plus 1 by 3 into 1 by 2 because dz by 2 half taking outside of the integration. Dz because x dx is equal to dz by 2, dz kept here and half taking outside of the integration becoming 1 plus x square is equal to z. Now, I am giving hints to you, some student commit some mistakes because they know the integration of x is equal to, they put immediately in this step without using integration, in this step using x square by 2, but there is a constant is coming here which is not written here. So, at last we using the integration and the constant, all the sum of the constant is equal to c. So, it is better process to write in this way. So, x cube by 3 tan inverse x minus 1 by 3 x square by 2, that constant is c1 and that constant is c2, c1 plus c2 is equal to c, that is 1 by 3 into 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 6 and ln z plus c. The c will means, that is c means that constant coming, that is c1 and that is c2, c2 minus c1 is equal to c because here is minus. Okay. Now, x cube by 3 tan inverse x plus 1 by 6, 3 into 2, 6 x square plus 1 by 6 ln the value of z is equal to 1 plus x square plus c, that is the answer of the integration. Okay. You look how I am solved this integration. This is the process to using, but to evaluate the integration value. So, now in this problem, the last number 4, I think VI, I am going to evaluate VI. Now, I am going to evaluate VI. So, VI. You look VI is sec inverse x dx, integration of a sec inverse x dx. Here sec inverse is a lone one function, but it is an inverse trigonometric function. So in this case, mind it, in this case you used one as second function. That is, the first function is a constant. Sec inverse x is a constant. Integration of a dx minus integration of a, what the derivative of sec inverse x is equal to 1 by x root of x square minus 1. That is the modulus value of x. X is always positive. That equal to integration of a dx whole dx. You look, integration of a dx is equal to x, no doubt. X sec inverse x minus of integration of dx equal to x, x by x into root over by x square minus 1 dx. So x x cancel. Now x sec inverse x, do you know dx by root over by x square minus 1 is equal to ln x plus or root over by x square minus 1 plus or c. That's your answer. That is your answer. Very easy process. You can solve in this way. So all about number 4. But you look number 5, 6, 7, 8. You look 6, 7, and 8 for a, all the problems are same category, same types. So from 6, 7, and 8, I am doing some problems, not all problems, but number 5, I am going to some problems. That is, from number 5, the important problems are, now you carefully look, number 5 VI. Number 5 VI is same as number 7 VI. Question number 5 VI bit is same number as 7 number VI. So no doubt I must done this problem. So I think in the remaining except VI, I am doing other two problems also number 5. Now I am going to number 5. Number I. That is very important, and then IV and number VI. Okay. Number 5 I. You look number 5 I. Number 5 I UG. E to the 3x cos 2x, dx, taking that integration as I means integration, taking e to the 3x into cos 2x as I, mind it is the hints for you, when in exponential function with a algebraic function or a trigonometric function, you take I, specially for a exponential function multiplied with a trigonometric function, you taking I, so I is equal to e to the 3x into cos 2x. So using integrating by first, so trigonometry is the fourth and e to exponential is the fifth function. So cos 2x is the first function and e to 3x is the second function. So I is equal to cos 2x is the constant, integration of e to the 3x dx minus integration of a cos 2x, derivative of cos 2x. Derivative of cos 2x is equal to, you know, derivative of cos 2x is equal to minus of 2 sin 2x, because derivative of cos 2x is minus sin 2x into minus 2. So that is minus 2 sin 2x into integration of e to the 3x whole dx. Okay. Now, integration of e to the 3x is equal to, you know, 1 by 3 e to the 3x into cos 2x minus of minus minus plus 2 e to the 3x into e to the 3x by 3. So 2 by 3 taking outside the integration, it becomes sin 2x into sin 2x into e to the 3x dx. You look, it becomes again integrating by parts. That is your first function and that is your second function. Again using integration by parts. So it is 1 by 3 e to the 3x cos of 2x plus of 2 by 3. The first function is a constant using integrating by parts 2x, integration of e to the 3x dx minus of derivative of sin 2x is equal to 2 cos 2x integration of u to the 3x dx whole dx. And that square bracket ending. Now you look 1 by 3 e to the power 3x cos 2x plus 2 by 3 integration of e to the 3x to 1 by 3 1 by 3 sin e 2x minus 2 e to the 3x to 2 by 3 cos 2x into that is e to the 3x into cos 2x dx bracket says you look that part equal to I. In this case, integration of e to the 3x cos 2x is equal to I. In this case also e to the 3x cos 2x. So, in this case you can put that is I. So, now we just you write without clearing this written materials, I am writing this part. So, I is equal to becomes I. I becomes 1 by 3 e to the power 3x cos 2x plus 2 by 3 into 1 by 3 that is a 2 by 9 sin 2x 2 by 3 into 2 by 3 minus 4 by 3 into I because that value is I. You look that value is I. So, instead of that value e to the 3x cos 2x we use I plus C1. So, minus 4 by 3 in the right side going to left side it became plus. So, minus I. I plus 4 by 3 I became 1 by 3 e to the 3 x cos 2 x sorry cos 2 x plus 2 by 9 sin 2 x plus C 1. You look I plus 4 by 3 is equal to 3 I plus 4 I 7 I by 3 7 I by 3 is equal to so I is equal to keta abo 7 by 3 is divided. So, 1 by 3 by 7 into 7 by 3 divided in this side became 3 by 7 multiplied 7 by 3 3 by 12 that becomes 3 by 7 voltage 3 by 7 is equal to 1 by 3 e to the 3 x plus 2 by 9 sin 2 x plus C 1 that becomes I becomes I is equal to 1 by 7 3 3 cancel abo e to the 3x cos 2x chadi jodi cos 2x lekhibo e to the 3x cos 2x 1 by 7 2x plus 3 3 cancel and that is abo 2 into 7 into 3 is 21 sin 2x where 3 by 7 into c1 is equal to c another constant c that is your answer. Look again look that particular part that is e to the 3x cos 2x that becomes I using I in this case became minus of 4 by 3 I plus 4 by 3 I is equal to 7 by 3 I 7 by 3 is multiplied in left side so hence it is divided into right side 1 by 7 by 3 is equal to 3 by 7 multiplied throughout the equation and that becomes 1 by 7 e to the 3x cos 2x plus 2 by 21 sin 2x plus c that's your answer that is your answer of this that is your answer of that particular number 5i. Then I am going to done number 5 IV 5 IV you look number 5 IV 5 IV is equal to x e to the x square into sin x square dx. In this case using substitute method put x square is equal to z put x square is equal to z because here is x square here is x square. So, dz is equal to 2x dx we have x dx dekho here is x dx x into dx but not 2x dx. So, dz by 2 is equal to x dx dz by 2 is equal to x dx. Now, so 1 by 2 e to the z plus sin z dz, taking I. So 2i is equal to, so 2i is equal to e to the z into sin z dz. You look, 2i is equal to, because 2 is divided, multiplied here 2i. From starting beginning, you look how to solve this question. So it is very easy, but not important, not complicated also. It is very easy process. I am going to solve and evaluate this integration. You look, it was z sin z, taking 2i, not I. Here it was z sin z, you know, 2i. So but our goal is I, not 2i. Our goal is I. So we have find the value of I. Now in this case, sin z is a trigonometrical function, e to the z is the exponential function. No doubt sin z is the first function and e to the z is the second function. So sin z is a constant, sin z is a constant. Integration of e to the z dz minus derivative of sin z is equal to cos z, integration of e to the z dz whole dz. You look, e to the z, integration of e to the z is equal to e to the z sin z minus integration of e to z is equal to cos z, e to the z into cos z dz. You look, again using integration by parts, again using integrating by parts. So that is equal to e to the z sin z minus the first function is cos z, integration of e to the z dz minus derivative of cos z is equal to minus minus plus, h will be plus, became plus sin z, because cos derivative of cos z to minus sin z, from before minus it became plus sin z, integration of e to the z dz whole dz. You look, e to the z sin z, that became e to the z cos z plus plus into minus into plus, that is minus bracket, in between bracket. So minus is from before bracket, so sign changes, plus into minus is minus, that is e to the z sin z dz. You look, we used e to the z sin z is equal to 2i. So instead of e to the z sin z, we are using 2i. So 2i is equal to, become that starting 2i. So 2i is equal to e to the z sin z minus of e to the z cos z minus of 2i, because that value is equal to 2i. We use that value is equal to 2i. So minus 2i plus c 1 also. So 2i minus 2i going to right side became plus. So 2i plus 2i is equal to 4i. So 4i is equal to e to the z taking common became sin z minus of cos z plus of c 1. So now I am going to in this step, last step of this say. So I is equal to 1 by 4 e to the z. The value of z is equal to x square, using value z of value, that is x square whole into sin x square minus of cos of x square plus of c. When divided by, you look, when 4 is divided with c 1, c 1 by 4 is equal to c. Because c 1 is a constant, c also a constant. So c 1 by 4 also a constant. So at instead of c 1 by 4, we use c. So why I am using c 1, you already understand, because c 1 by 4 is equal to c. Here I have write c. So that is your answer. You look in this way, and that and last, at last that I is equal to it. So that's all about your number 5. I am going to number 5 is number VI. Because number 5 VI also you are faced in number 7 VI. It is very important for you. 7 VI. That particular problems repeated twicely at 5 VI and also in 7 VI. Both in case are same number are repeated. Now I am going to this particular important problems. Particular that problem I am going to solve. number 5 VI. If I already complete, when I complete evaluate the VI, you already find the result of VI of 7 also. So it is very important for you. Number VI, 5 VI, integration of, integrating value of 2x square plus 1, 2x square plus 1 e to the power x square dx. Hey, you look, x square, the derivative of x square, you will 2x, so e to the power x square is here, so taking 2x common on both, taking 2x common, 2x, where taking 2x common, here is x by 1 by 2x, no doubt, the, if 2x is multiplied here, 2x into x is equal to x square, 2x by 2x is equal to 1. Now, e to the x square dx. Put z is equal to x square. So, dz is equal to 2x dx. You look, 2x and here is dx. 2x dx. That is dz. Where x is equal to root z. X is equal to, because x square is equal to z. So, x is equal to root z. Put the value. Instead of x, where e to the x square is equal to e to the z, where x is equal to root z, and 1 by 2x is equal to 1 by 2 root z, that is 2x dx is equal to dz, 2x dx is equal to dz, that is the trick. You look from variable x and taking in z form. Now, became the important problem now for you, waiting for you now. The most important activity, most important activity is waiting for you from this, after this step, okay? That is root z into e to the power of root z dz.